light again. Steady and reliable after years in which darkness or uncertainty were nightly commonplace. But Berlin still remembers and remembers well the months just after the war, before the lights went on. And the years later on when West Berlin's electrical supply came from the surrounding Russian zone and could be cut off at the Soviets' will. Berlin remembers. And so does Berliner Hans Luther. Hans is a machinist in the new power plant which today supplies the three western sectors of the city. Operating at only half of ultimate capacity, it is turning out all the current free Berlin can use. Sometimes, Hans and his wife, at home in the evening, reading or working, think back to those first 3 years after the war. There were no lights then, except for a few uncertain hours each day or night. No lights, no power, no heat. For a time, Berlin almost ceased to function as a city. It had become little more than an inhabited ruin. The great power station that had once supplied Berlin with electricity was dead, looted and dismantled by the Red Army. They had stripped it of every turbine and dynamo, every generator and transformer for shipment east to Russia or the communist satellite nations. For 3 long years, Western Berlin was totally dependent upon power from the Soviet zone. Then in April of 1948, designers and engineers went to work, backed up by the Western Allies and the Magistrate of West Berlin. Restoring the wrecked plant was vitally necessary to bring the city's shattered economy back to life again. Hans Lütke and lots of others who used to hold jobs in the plant were hired to help rebuild it. The rebuilding went on in the face of one obstacle after another. In those days before currency reform in Germany, nobody wanted to sell tools, material, or machinery for money that might soon be worthless. And it was hard for workmen to keep going on the Berlin food ration of 1948. But they kept on, 2,000 of them, working day and night. Then came the blockade of Berlin. The Soviets cut the road and rail links to the city, isolating 2.25 million people. Overnight, electric power from the Russian zone switched off. With these tactics, the Soviet expected to strangle the economic life of the Western sectors within weeks. But they had not counted on the Western Allies. For months, everything to keep West Berlin alive, everything for the power plant was flown in. By fall of 1948, the structure was finished and ready to receive the machinery. But there was another long, harsh winter to be got through without lights. After nearly a year, the blockade was defeated. The nightmare was over. Now the way was free again. Trucks and trains were bringing food and supplies into the liberated city. Machinery for the electric plant no longer had to be flown in a piece at a time. The work of installing the machinery bought with Marshall Plan funds went ahead faster than ever. Then came the day when all of official Berlin gathered to mark a great occasion. The first completed power units were ready to go into operation. Today, Free Berlin need no longer fear another Soviet blackout. Already, Power Station West is supplying nearly 100,000 kilowatts of electricity, enough for all the city's homes and industries. The long night of hardship and uncertainty is over now. There is light again in Free Berlin.